Now, this works pretty well. What should we have done different? There's always those things. We have them against the wall. What we found out later, we should have put a 6-inch air gap in between it. You know how air gaps can give you insulation? We should have done that. So that's what we would have done a little bit differently. You also notice all of our inside is very reflective. Again, that helps with our heat. Also, it's easy to wash. Also, it's water tolerant, I should say. Because any type of greenhouse, we will have some water issues from time to time. Now, as you see, we've been measuring the temperature drop, the rise and the drop. So we do get both inside and outside. And we've shown that we have not fallen where we are frozen yet because of this passive heat. Now, what some other issues that we would have done differently? Well, as you can see, we have all of this glazing. And at night, clear nights like we often have in the wintertime, there's really nothing for the greenhouse to equilibrate with except the universe. And we'll drop a lot of degrees in here. What we attempted to do after the fact was put a curtain in here that we could lower down at night. And this way, this would help trap a lot of the heat in here. It hasn't worked as well as we wanted to, but I'm sure other folks can engineer something much better than what we can. But that would be very, very important to be able to do this in the evening. We also, of course, it gets warm in here, and we have fans on a thermostat that kick on that gets rid of the excess heat. But remember, we don't want to get rid of too much excess heat because we want to warm our water up very, very well. Now the question becomes, well, what if I want to be totally off the grid? A couple of things you could do. One thing is that you could put your plastic on both sides of your 2x4s. That would give you that air gap. You don't have to have that squirrel cage fan. You can also just manually open and lower your louvers every day. Of course, that would mean every day you have to do this a couple times a day. There are these heat sensitive actuators that you could put on your vent that would open automatically when the heat got, you know, above 90 or 95 degrees or however you want to set that. So there's ways of getting this off the grid. Or you could maybe get this on a solar collector where the solar could run your fans. And that could take out a lot of your heat that way too. So this is possibilities of this being totally off the grid. One other thing we might look at, this is 20 years old. We built this in 2005. They're starting to warp a little bit, but not bad. And also, we put down weed barrier underneath the gravel. We should have probably went with some insulation in the soil too, because we do lose some heat that way. So there's lots of different ways that we can insulate this to make it as most efficient as possible. And as you've noticed before, this is standing out in the middle of the prairie. If you built this into a hill, think about the thermal insulation that you could have got from the soil around it. So that's another aspect of this, that you could have this surrounded by soil, again, with the barrels in here, and just your sheeting being exposed. And that's a great way that you can really help the insulation of this solar greenhouse. You know, other aspects of trying to heat this more passively would be using, you know, the heat from compost that you could have that's trapped in there as it composts. That could be pumped through, the heat could be pumped through heating water through your floor. So there's other ways that you can heat this, not just with the barrels, or in addition with the barrels. So if you want to make this larger, you say, well, I need more than just 12 feet. Well, you just have to make it, you just have to make sure you get this aspect of 2:1:1 the same, and then you can make it as large or small as you would like to. So on our video, we have all the resources that we've talked about. We have the cost of what this was in 2005. We also have photographs as we were constructing it, and also these numbers again about how many barrels to have for your greenhouse. We'll talk to you next time.